నమస్కారం. హ్యాపీ అండ్ ప్రౌడ్ టు అడ్రస్ ది ప్రెస్ అట్ నిజామాబాద్. ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ ది తెలంగాణ ఆర్ ఆంధ్ర ఇస్ నాట్ న్యూ టు మీ. ఐ వాజ్ ఇన్ఛార్జ్ ఆఫ్ బోత్ స్టేట్ వెన్ వైఎస్ఆర్ రాజశేఖర్ రెడ్డి వాస్ హియర్. And you know, I worked for 4 years, and at that time Congress was pacific. I can really see that kind of a regime is not here in Telangana. It's most unfortunate. We created a state. I was the law minister. I myself drafted the law to bifurcate and also to create Telangana. This Telangana state has been very dear to our leader Sonia ji. Another day she came for a meeting here in the at lecture. The address which she gave is that she said that I always feel that is my baby and I have mothered it. That means to say the Congress has a very warm, affectionate relationship with Telangana. Of course, at the same time, Congress had to sacrifice. This is the greatest sacrifice Congress has made, you know, by losing out both states. And last time we really thought that having created Telangana, Congress would come back to power, last assembly election. But at the same time, there was an impression given by K. Chandrasekhar Rao, which is Chief Minister now, that it's not only an impression, I was also a witness when he said that I will merge my party with the Congress immediately. And he also said that, you know, he doesn't want the chief ministership, he wants only Telangana to be created. He gave a pretext of, you know, of a sentiment that Telangana is very close to his heart. But we never knew at that time that only the power was close to his heart, not Telangana. That difference we could not make out. We have been truthful. Congress has been very truthful. And you know, the Chandrasekhar Rao has not been truthful. He was only after getting into power. I'm going to say that, you know, how things have gone. You know, he said, at one point of time, I will be the CLP leader, let anybody from the Congress be the chief minister. That was the, what he said, an unwritten agreement. But the power was not in our agenda. Creation of Telangana was the agenda of the Congress party. This is the difference. Congress has always, for the integrity of the country, for the best interest of the country, Congress has always made sacrifice. We are Congress is known for that. Okay, whenever you don't understand, please let me know. You know, you take any history in any part of the country. For example, Mizoram, there was a Congress chief minister. But we wanted to ensure that, you know, country should be one. Not in a single part of the country should be away from us. That's why we made Lal Danga, who was a really working for a separatism. He was not, we made him the chief minister so that Mizoram will always remain as an integral part of India. We sacrificed our chief minister. When Jammu and Kashmir question also came, that, you know, there was a very strong wave that they don't want to remain with the Congress. Then, you know, we sacrificed our chief minister and made, you know, passed over the mantle of power to shake up. He was not our chief minister was there. We sacrificed. You know, even when it came to the Assam and to, you know, douse the fire of agitation, revolt there, Congress sacrificed so that the other party, AGM, came to power. I'm just telling you, this is the history of the Congress. Of course, we, I don't say that we are lost, we have come back to power in all those days. Even here, in transit, the voters thought that KCR, you know, recommend, you know, the represent the people of Telangana, and Congress is with him. And at the cost of the Congress party, he came to power. He took votes. And at least, you know, he should, there are aspirations of Telangana. Why the Telangana was created? Telangana was created, you know, to meet the aspirations of the people of Telangana. We all thought that we expected, you know, it was initially, government was formed, we gave an impression that it is still with the government. It was only a pretense, we did not understand. And what happened? He, his people also came to parliament. TRS, immediately they came, they acted more loyal to the BJP than anybody else. Even the BJP members were not that supporting, but his members were, you know, the BJP says, you stand up, they stand up. If they say, sit down, they will sit down in the parliament. I witnessed, I mean, clear witness to it. And when any issue with regard to Sri Modi or his government, TRS there to help them, support them. Even when he wanted, you know, the election to be advanced from May 19 to this day, the election commission was elected. They did not accede to it. But ultimately, it is the Prime Minister who prevailed upon the election commission to concede to the demand of Chandrasekhar Rao and advanced, because we know the intention. Intention was, he knew very well, that if Telangana also goes with the assembly election, also goes with the parliament election, culminates with it, Muslim minorities will not go with the, will not vote the Modi. That means it will also work against it. He made that political calculation. But now he wants the vote of Muslim. At that time, you know, in a, the, it was not. Now you know very well, there's a gang up with BJP, TRS and Majlis, MIM. MIM, throughout they were with the Congress party. You know, after he became friends to KCR, and through KCR, they friend to Modi, they have also fallen out from there. If BJP or Modi is against minorities, what he has done, you know, how suppressed, you know, that lynching cases, separation, you are now, you know, how they create divide. If the vote is given to TRS, vote will be given to BJP, vote is given to Majlis. All combined is a drama, you know, which is being played in the country. How untruthful they are. You know, they can very openly say, yes, we work together. They know very well, in South India, BJP has no place today. Andhra and Telangana, BJP has no place. They want to make only back entry, not a front door entry. Tamil Nadu is concerned, there is no, you know, they are trying to woo the ADMK. Even they cannot openly come and say that we are with BJP. Through ADMK, they would like to enter the election parade. Kerala is concerned, they are day in and night, they create law and order situation. It is only NDF. LDF versus UDF. UDF is led by Congress. LDF is led by Congress, the Communist Party of India. So, there again, they try, you know, since decades after independence. And it is work is, you know, it is cost 45,000 crores. And that 45,000 crores is given to a one single contractor. Patently open corruption, it is done. And I don't think any other state, any other party government has given a single contractor 45,000 crores contract. I don't think you require any other manifestation to show that, you know, this is, you know, old age pension is concerned. You know, we have openly said, Congress party, that we'll give 2,000 rupees old age pension as against 1,000 given by him. Now he said, I will give 200 crores more, 216 rupees more. That's all. I don't think, you know, it is an afterthought, but it is offer of 2,000 is our original idea. Then farmers, cultivation, that it is only farmers 8,000 rupees per annum. We have now promised, Congress has promised, to extend this scheme to the landless cultivators. It is cultivation done by the landless people. It meant only to the landholder, but we have extended to land. I don't think, you know, these are the things, you know, which will go in their favor. Yes. Then, you know, the tribals are concerned. Yes, then let it get, you know, greatest harm to the Goti Koya tribal violence has taken place. 40 tribal families were evicted forcibly by the police forces. And, you know, the many of them, even, you know, Congress party, at the instance of Sonia ji, he brought in a tribal settlement act to settle the land to the tribal. Whereas, you know, these people, TRS government has not implemented that. In fact, you know, there are many things which, you know, we had Congress government earlier to is coming to power. You know, it was in the forefront. Both United Andhra Pradesh government was in the forefront. You know, we had given free power to the farmers at that time. Waiver of power bill dues, farm loan waivers, special package for farmers not covered under farm loan waiver scheme, compensation to families of farmers, Raju Arogya Sri, that is all in the dump. That scheme, very important scheme, and, you know, many other states, including Karnataka, adopted that scheme. Raju Gandhi Arogya Sri, that has been dumped. 108 emergency ambulance service, that is a model to the entire country. 104 medical services. Fee reimbursement to students. Jala Yajnam, it was the biggest scheme, best scheme, most efficient scheme. You know, under that, you know, very, very many, you know, the project have been adopted and implemented. Many LIC scheme, lift irrigation scheme, many, more than 10 in number. The Congress government has planned several power plants in Telangana to meet the ever-growing demand. The power scheme, many of the central government power scheme to the NTPC also implemented it. Minority reservation we had provided. The KCR, you know, he promised 12% reservation to the minority. 12% reservation to the minority, and he could not implement it. We had implemented. Pavana Vatti scheme, that is the most popular because I was an eyewitness to many of these schemes. When, you know, YSR was here. And Indiramma housing scheme for poor, social security pensions for old age, widows and disabled, land distribution scheme, more than 7.67 lakh eligible landless beneficiaries got land between 2005 and 2012. Then Abhayasthan Bureau program, contributory pension scheme, statutory status to scheduled caste sub-plan and tribal sub-plan. You know, in Karnataka also we implemented that, wherein special component tribal scheme, we mandated by a legislation. So every year that has to be, it is about 29 to 30,000 crores per annum, allotted only as it been done here. I don't think this is implemented here. Jawaharlal Nehru Outer Ring Road, Rajiv Gandhi Hyderabad International Airport, all done by Congress Party. P.V. Narasimharao, PVNR Expressway, Pranahita Chawla Lift Irrigation Project. It is renamed by the present government as Kaleshwaram Scheme. And you know how the money has been siphoned. 54,000 crores, the biggest scandal of the century. Drinking water to Hyderabad from Krishna and Godavari River, Hyderabad Metro Rail projects, and rural employment, Congress government effectively implemented central schemes, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee. It was a scheme of the government of India. You all know mandatory, the work should be given 150 days per annum, isn't it? Whereas, minimum 150 days. Karnataka, we are giving that. Whereas in Telangana, instead of 150 days, what is the average? 47 days? 47, 48 days. That means even the government of India program, which we had implemented, TRS government, they failed to implement this scheme. They failed. Because this is the basic work which is given, 150 days work. That is again, and all this front, you know, I have listed out flagship program. There is no seriousness in implementing it. And today, because of the failure of the government, you know, and the Congress had, you know, even those programs they could not implement. Apart from the education, it is most backward. Employment generation in the KCR regime is the worst. I think this is the third highest unemployment in the country. First highest in Tripura, next highest in Chhattisgarh, third highest in Telangana. Just imagine. He promised it 1 lakh jobs per annum. The third highest unemployment here. And second, according to the assessment made by various agencies, the second most corrupt government in the country. Second most corrupt government. Second highest farmer society in Telangana, after Maharashtra, second highest. Then as far as the poverty is concerned, again, poverty program is concerned, highest poverty, sixth highest crime rate in India according to NCBR report, it's not our report. Sixth highest crime rate in India, Telangana. Fourth highest crimes rate against women in Telangana. He promised Dalit CM, he voted to power. He betrayed that. And, you know, there are also the poverty rating is concerned. Again, the poverty, highest poverty here. Highest poverty here. Take up creation of Telangana. You know, the 369 students died in police firing during the movement. And some life in the second phase of the Telangana agitation. How many got the paper? I think only 400. And that too, they are not doing rehabilitation of their family. No jobs are due. No employment is due. You know, just, you know, the people are just waiting for the election day to come to demonstrate their anger against this government. And any parameter you take, you know, this government has ignored. And they insulted the martyrs of Telangana
by not paying compulsion to all of them. This is what, you know, what things have happened, and I've already told you that, you know, the highest farmer societies in the country, and any parameter, you know, this is the worst government, and people will have to be liberated. Congress has come to liberate. Congress has a record, a legacy of performance, providing employment, and, you know, passing pro, you know, poor, this thing, and much, but, you know, perform least. And, you know, the investment profile is also concerned. People are not willing to come here because they have to pay money and come. Investment is lowest. I have seen the CMI report also. The lowest, you know, it was the highest. Hyderabad, particularly the IT industry. I am the real creator of IT industries in Karnataka as a CM and also industry minister. That is why today IT is concerned. It is parallel to the Silicon Valley of US today. During YSR time, it was just picking up to take off, to compete with Bangalore. Now, instead of competing, it is, you know, degrading every day by day. Nizamabad district is concerned, particular issues are concerned, and in the absence of irrigation, irrigation water, the output of Nizamabad's major crop has been declining steadily day by day. And output of rice fell 57%. Nizamabad, why should the Nizamabad people should vote, you know, the KCR? And, you know, I got the figure. Rice fell 57% from 620,525 meter tons in 2014-15 to just 2,62,787, from 6 lakh to 2 lakh. No, here the farmers feel the brunt of this government. Production of maize fell 36% from 2,84,000 metric tons in 2014-15 to 79,729 metric tons. And turmeric production fell 28% from 47,000 metric tons in 2014-15 to 33,821. And sugarcane, you know, turmeric farmers are reeling under losses due to absence of minimum support price. They don't come out. You know, minimum support price operation will have to be done when the price is depressed. That has not been. Sugarcane production too fell 17% from 47,449 metric tons in 2014-15 to 39,250 tons. TRS MP Kavita had promised revival of Nizam sugar factory within 100 days of coming to power. 100 days. But they failed. Sugarcane farmers have sworn to kick TRS out of Nizamabad. This is the determination. And they don't want them. Water crisis is garbage problem. You know, all that has been cropping up here. Having been in charge of, you know, joint Andhra and Telangana at that particular time, having seen today, when I compare it today, then development, social welfare, all these programs in the Nadi, the lowest M. I don't think, you know, this Telangana deserves it. Telangana really deserves development. Telangana people, farmers, deserve their justice, which can be given only by the Congress government. And Congress is looking up, of course, he said, when dissolving the assembly here, declaring election, he thought he is in the peak, in the sky. Now he has been fallen to the nadir, fallen to the earth, and, you know, the definitely, you know, the, where was the necessity to call for an election? What is the motive to call for an election? And that is, I think, the people are ready to punish him for having done all this, starting with the betrayal of the Congress, betrayal of the various sections of the people, betrayal of every section of the people, they feel that this government should go and Congress should come again to revive the glory of Telangana, glory of Hyderabad, Nizamabad, all these regions.